Hi, I'm Cookie, and I sincerely want to get this insincerity started. Only two of you, huh? I haven't seen this many people since my homeschool graduation. Let's do this. This is round one, and that means you get 500 points for fooling your opponent with your made-up answer. And you'll get 1,000 for finding the truth. Select a category. Okay, here's your first question. Gloucestershire, England is home to the Cotswold Olympics, the highlight of which is the traditional blank-kicking competition. Now, use your device to enter a bluff that you think will fool your opponent into thinking it's true. If you can't think of anything in time, use the Lie for Me button for half the points. Do it now! Hurry! Hit the Lie for Me button if you can't think of something. Okay, here are your choices. Find the truth and touch it on your device. Let's see what everybody selected. Well, you guys blew it. And that means this lie didn't get picked. Alright, pick a category. Okay, here's the question. According to a Chinese myth, if a vampire comes across a sack of rice, he must blank. Type in your lies now. Okay, here are your choices. Alright, let's see what everybody picked. And if they come across Anne Rice, they have to thank her for making them popular. And the rest of the board goes unselected. Time to pick a category. Okay, here's the question. After consuming antifreeze, a Maltese Terrier in Australia had his life saved when vets then gave him blank to drink. Enter your lies now. Alright, where's the truth? Okay, let's take a look. And then the Maltese Terrier told them what he really thought of them. And nobody picked the other lies up there. Now it's round two, where all point values are doubled. Let's do it. All right, pick a category. Okay, here's the question. Budget hotel chain Travelodge reported that between 2006 and 2007, about 95% of sleepwalkers found in their hotels were blank men. Type in your lies now. Okay, here you go. Find the truth. All right, who picked what? And that's it. Nobody else's lies got picked. Select a category. Okay, here's the question. Coca-Cola once commissioned a video game from Atari called Pepsi Blank. Enter your lies now. Okay, which one's the truth? Okay, what did everyone pick? And we're done. Time to pick a category. Okay, here's the question. Callum Wright, while a student at UC Berkeley, started an organization named Students Against Blank in Trees. Type in your lies now. Okay, here are your choices. All right, let's see what everybody picked. Put hippies where they belong, lecturing in front of our college students. And that means... It's time for the final fibbage. Just one final question, and it's worth triple. Good luck. Here's your final fibbage question. Former First Lady Barbara Bush wrote an official apology letter to this fictional character in 1990. Enter your lies now. Okay, here you go. Find the truth. Okay, let's take a look. The letter said, "I'm sorry I had a cow." And that means some of these didn't get picked. Welcome to the game. My name's Cookie, but if a detective visits you, I'm Brent. It looks like a two-person game. Sounds good. This way I can phone it in. Let's do this. This is round one. You'll get 500 points for fooling your opponent with your lie. And you'll get 1,000 for finding the truth. All right, pick a category. Okay, here's your first question. In 1518, hundreds of people in Strasbourg became afflicted with a bizarre condition that rendered them unable to stop blank. Type in your lies now. All right, Where's the truth? Let's see what everybody selected. And nobody fell for some of these ingenious lies. Time to pick a category. Okay, here's the question. One of Kim Jong-il's many titles was invincible and ever-triumphant general and highest incarnation of the revolutionary comradely blank. Enter your lies now. Okay, here are your choices. Alright, who picked what? Well, don't you feel foolish. Or IAETGAHIOTRCL for short. And nobody picked the other lies up there. Select a category. Okay, here's the question. Psycho was the first American movie to show a blank. Type in your lies now. Okay, which one's the truth? Okay, let's take a look. And we're done. This is round two, which means all point values are doubled. Exciting! Time to pick a category. Okay, here's the question. Actor Eddie Murphy released a dance song in 1982 titled Boogie in Blank. Enter your lies now. Okay, here you go. Find the truth. All right, let's see what everybody picked. And look what we have here. And nobody fell for this one. All right, pick a category. Okay, here's the question. A Rhode Island middle school discovered that some students were crushing Smarties candy and then snorting the dust. So they sent an email to parents warning that a side effect of this activity could be blank in their kids' noses. Type in your lies now. Okay, here are your choices. Let's see what everybody selected. you guys blew it. And look at what we have left. One single, lonely, pitiful lie. Time to pick a category. Okay, here's the question. In 1988, George H.W. Bush celebrated Halloween by dressing up as blank. Enter your lies now. Okay, which one's the truth? Okay, what did everyone pick? Well, don't you feel foolish. And we're done. Welcome to the final fibbage. This is your final question, and it's worth triple. It's anybody's game. Okay, here is your final fibbage question. Brand name of the patented synthetic testicles for pets. Type in your lies now. All right, where's the truth? Okay, let's take a look. A cheaper option is to just not cut your dog's testicles off. And that means... Welcome to Fibbage. I'm Cookie, and I promise that almost everybody will make it out alive. Two players? Great. The faster the game goes, the sooner I can work on my porcelain doll collection. Let's do this. This is round one, and that means you get 500 points for fooling your opponent with your made-up answer. And you'll get 1,000 for finding the truth. Select a category. Okay, here's your first question. Metrophilia is sexual arousal caused by blank. Enter your lies now. Okay, here are your choices. All right, let's see what everybody picked. And that's it. Nobody else's lies got picked. Time to pick a category. Okay, here's the question. A Swedish man who works as a dishwasher receives disability benefits due to his unusual addiction to blank. Type in your lies now. Okay, here you go. Find the truth. All right, who picked what? And the rest of the board goes unselected. All right, pick a category. Okay, here's the question. When soccer player Stefan Schwarz signed with Sunderland in 1999, the team made sure that his contract specifically prohibited him from traveling to blank. Enter your lies now. Okay, which one's the truth? Let's see what everybody selected. He was hoping to take a commercial flight to outer space, or as they call it in Europe, foot space. And that means some of these didn't get picked. Now it's round two, where all point values are doubled. Let's do it. Time to pick a category. Well, we ain't waiting forever. Okay, here's the question. Chad Orzel wrote the book How to Teach Blank to Your Dog. Type in your lies now. Okay, here are your choices. Okay, let's take a look. Then maybe your dog can teach physics to me. And that means... Select a category. Okay, here's the question. In 2013, researchers at the University of Tokyo developed the incendiary reflection, a mirror that makes it look like you're blank. Enter your lies now. Okay, here you go. Find the truth. Okay, what did everyone pick? And that's it. Nobody else's lies got picked. Time to pick a category. Okay, here's the question. It's time for a road trip. When in Lafayette, Louisiana, be sure to check out their somewhat erotic statue of a shirtless blank. Type in your lies now. Hurry up, use a All right, where's the truth? All right, who picked what? If somewhat erotic isn't your speed, check out the pantsless firefighter statue one town over. And nobody picked the other lies up there. This is the final fibbage. One question left for all the marbles, and everything is worth triple. Good luck. Here's your final fibbage question. When Milton Bradley first acquired the rights to it, the game Twister was called this. Enter your lies now. Okay, here are your choices. All right, let's see what everybody picked. And look what we have here. And the rest of the board goes unselected. Welcome to the game. I'm your host, Cookie, but you can call me Cookie. Well, look at you, two little peas in a pod. Delicious. Let's do this. This is round one. You'll get 500 points for fooling your opponent with your lie, and you'll get 1,000 for finding the truth. All right, pick a category. Okay, here's your first question. The real name of the internet's famous grumpy cat is blank. Type in your lies now. Okay, here you go. Find the truth. Okay, what did everyone pick? Thank you, WikiLeaks. And nobody fell for some of these ingenious lies. Time to pick a category. Okay, here's the question. New Mexico State Senator Duncan Scott successfully got a bill passed in the New Mexico Senate requiring psychiatrists testifying in court to wear a blank. Enter your lies now. Okay, which one's the truth? All right, who picked what? Well, you guys blew it. The bill did not make it past the New Mexico House, however. They declared that a courtroom is no place for funny outfits unless you're the judge. And we're done. Select a category. Okay, here's the question. The New York Times was forced to issue a correction after they incorrectly identified the Nintendo characters Mario and Luigi as blank instead of plumbers. Type in your lies now. Okay, here are your choices. Let's see what everybody selected. And the rest of the board goes unselected. This is round two, which means all point values are doubled. Exciting! All right, pick a category. Okay, here's the question. Johnny Depp was made an honorary member of the Comanche Nation and given a descriptive Comanche name. His Comanche name, Mawumay, means blank. Enter your lies now. Okay, here you go. Find the truth. Okay, let's take a look. Which is short for man who shifts into white face makeup time after time. And nobody picked the other lies up there. Time to pick a category. Okay, here's the question. A man from Enniskillen, Northern Ireland, was sentenced to 3 months in prison for a fire he started while trying to turn blank into gold. Type in your lies now. All right, where's the truth? All right, who picked what? Yet nobody has ever arrested Rob Schneider. Heyo! And that means... Alright, pick a category. Okay, here's the question. In 2013, Dell issued a recall after customers complained their laptop smelled like blank. Enter your lies now. Okay, which one's the truth? Okay, what did everyone pick? Ah! And nobody fell for some of these ingenious lies. Fibbage. This is your final question, and it's worth triple. It's anybody's game. Okay, here is your final Fibbage question. Item that teachers at Mounts Bay Academy in England were banned from using in 2014. Type in your lies now. Okay, here are your choices. All right, let's see what everybody picked. There was a sentence fragment in the memo, and there was nothing they could do about it. And that's it. Nobody else's lies got picked. Hello, I'm your host, Cookie Masterson, and before we get started, I just want to say, you're welcome. Alrighty, two players. Let me just write that down so I don't forget. Two players. Okay, let's do this. This is round one, and that means you get 500 points for fooling your opponent with your made-up answer. And you'll get 1,000 for finding the truth. Select a category. Okay, here's your first question. A study conducted at Tufts University by psychology grad student Nicholas Rule found that people have the ability to point out blank in a crowd. Enter your lies now. Okay, here you go. Find the truth. Let's see what everybody selected. Well, don't you feel foolish? And nobody fell for this one. All right, pick a category. Okay, here's the question. Blair Tolman wrote a self-help book called Blank for Under a Dollar, 301 Ideas. Type in your lies now. Okay, here are your choices. All right, who picked what? Disclaimer, all of them will be first dates. And that means some of these didn't get picked. Time to pick a category. Okay, here's the question. Evergreen Cemetery includes an odd statue of Jesus wearing blank. Enter your lies now. is the truth? Okay, let's take a look. Evergreen Cemetery is, of course, in Texas. And nobody picked the other lies up there. Now it's round two, where all point values are doubled. Let's do it. All right, pick a category. Okay, here's the question. Bill Bennett made news in 2004 when he was able to sell just a single ordinary blank on eBay. Type in your lies now. Okay, which one's the truth? All right, let's see what everybody picked. And that's it. Nobody else's lies got picked. Select a category. Okay, here's the question. The city of Olney, Illinois, organizes an annual event in order to blank squirrels. Enter your lies now. Okay, here are your choices. Okay, what did everyone pick? It's important to count those who cannot count themselves. And nobody fell for some of these ingenious lies. Time to pick a category. Okay, here's the question. Pam Anderson wrote a book of recipes with the title How to Cook Without a Blank. Type in your lies now. All right, where's the truth? Okay, let's take a look. Step one, throw this book out. And the rest of the board goes unselected. For the final fibbage. Just one final question, and it's worth triple. Good luck. Here's your final fibbage question. Dr. Francis M. Fessmeyer's surefire remedy for stopping your hiccups. Enter your lies now. Okay, here you go. Find the truth. Let's see what everybody selected. strangely, that's also Dr. Fessmeyer's remedy for measles, leukemia, athlete's foot, and baldness. And we're done.
Yeah. How goes it? And welcome to Lie Swatter, the massive true or false trivia game. We can accommodate a huge number of players in a game. More players than you can probably get to play right now. And yes, that is a challenge. All right then. Before we get started, don't forget, new players can go to this website and enter this room code to join the game at any time. Let's go! You're going to see seven crazy facts pulled from the following fact categories. In his first appearance, Count Chocula was killed by sunlight. Use your device to pick whether you think the fact is true or a lie. People fart on average 14 times a day. Hunter S. Thompson promised to rename Aspen, Colorado, Fat City if elected sheriff. Gandhi grew up in northern Scotland. The minivan was designed for an episode of the Brady Bunch. A company in Canada makes edible urinal cakes. Eddie Murphy sued Miss Piggy. And here's where everyone stands at the end of round one. Here are your new fact categories. The world's largest working electric guitar is on top of the Hard Rock Cafe in Minnesota. Hitler had three testicles. Bear Grylls rode 22 miles while naked and in a bathtub. The MPAA's PG movie rating used to be known as GP. Zero gravity makes erections in space impossible. Elephants are not related to woolly mammoths or mastodons. Dirty Dancing was originally going to be sponsored by Clearasil. Here are your scores. For the final round, all the facts will be about one category. That category is world leaders. Which of these facts about world leaders are true and which are lies? Mikhail Gorbachev was briefly a spokesperson for Pizza Hut. Saddam Hussein published a romance novel. Okay. Yasser Arafat wrote a fan letter to the voice of SpongeBob SquarePants? Prince Charles speaks Klingon. Tony Blair got his hair braided on a trip to the Caribbean. Fidel Castro lost 60 pounds after joining Weight Watchers. Winston Churchill wore a hat in the shower. Let's see the final scores. It's time for another game of Lie Swatter. You're going to see seven crazy facts pulled from the following fact categories. Michael Jackson has an uncredited cameo in Home Alone. The Jesus Christ lizard is a species of lizard that can run on water. France had its last death by guillotine in the 1970s. A strain of bacteria that causes insanity in lab rats was named Melis Gibsonium. Tap water in Monaco is mildly flavored with spearmint. A.A. Milne's son, Christopher Robin, was teased about the poo books at school. Zachary Taylor was the first U.S. president to keep a pet pig in the White House. And here's where everyone stands at the end of round one. Here are your new fact categories. Vin Diesel has a 3.14 tattoo on his lower back. Red M&Ms were discontinued in 1976 over fear that they caused cancer. In space, astronauts' screams are actually amplified. Wow. Kiss had to cancel a 2004 reunion tour because Gene Simmons got mono. In Bolivia, there's a hotel made almost entirely of salt. World War I German U-boat sailors were instructed to patch small leaks with thin slices of raw bacon. Wow. Al Capone's brother was a prohibition officer. Here are your scores. For the final round, all the facts will be about one category. That category is words in the U.S. Constitution. Some of these words really appear in the Constitution. Others we're lying about. Separation of church and state.
Wow.
God. A misspelled Pennsylvania. Erection. Let's party. Freedom of speech. Democracy.
Wow.
Let's see the final scores.
Masterson, and I shaved my nipples for this, so let's hurry before it grows back. Like, we need to get moving now. You two are going head-to-head, huh? Try not to hurt yourselves. Everybody's got their screws. If you think an opponent doesn't know the answer, hit your screw button, and you'll force them to answer immediately. If they miss it, you win big. And today's wrong answer of the game is brought to you by
Flavored Eye Drops. Why let your mouth have all the fun? Flavored Eye Drops.
If you happen to find our sponsor's wrong answer to the game, you'll be rewarded with big prizes and cash. So let's get to it.
Get ready, time for question.
One.
First question. Eat, pray, die. Which of these Julia Roberts characters would Jack the Ripper have been most likely to savagely murder? Erin Brockovich, Vivian Ward, Tess Ocean, or Liz Gilbert? Player 2? Any last words? Not too late. Player 1? This answer is worth Ocean 0. The correct answer is... Vivian Ward is the name of the prostitute Julia Roberts plays in Pretty Woman, and almost all of serial killer Jack the Ripper's alleged victims were female prostitutes, so he'd probably have just loved to murder her. I can see it now. He'd open the box with his knife in it. She'd reach in and he'd playfully shut it, snapping her fingers. She'd laugh, he'd laugh, then he'd kill her. Here we have, If I Only Had a Brain Trust. Suppose the Scarecrow from The Wizard of Oz faced off against the Wicked Witch of the West in a public debate. If he wanted to use a straw man argument against her, what might he do? Attack the Wicked Witch's character rather than the issues? Misrepresent the Wicked Witch's position on the issues? Prove the Wicked Witch wrong using statistical data? Or interrupt the Wicked Witch before she finishes her point? Player one. Player two. A straw man argument purposefully misrepresents an opponent's position in order to strike it down. Here's how I would debate the Wicked Witch. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the two candidates you see here tonight is a Wicked Witch. Thank you, I yield the rest of my time.
Dance with me, Disco 3.
May I introduce... Getting Naughty, and this diss or dat leg's being tied up. Player one, I want you to play this diss or dat since you're behind at the moment. I'm gonna read off seven names, and for each one, you tell me if it's the name of a necktie knot or the name of a sex position recommended by Women's Health Magazine. If it's a necktie knot, press the square button. If it's a sex position, press the circle button. Player two, lock in your answer before player one, because if player one gets it wrong and you get it right, you steal the cash. Okay, let's move. The Half Windsor. The Valedictorian. The Prince Albert. The Trinity. The Caboose. The Chairman. The Four in Hand. You're way out of position. My usual sex position is also the way I usually tie a tie, alone in front of a mirror. Pucker up for Shop Till Everyone Drops. Say at Christmas time, every single item at your local mall sells out. According to a popular Grimm fairy tale, which of these stores has the best chance to be magically stocked overnight by hardworking elves? Foot Locker, Radio Shack, Victoria's Secret, or Lens Crafters? Player 2? Oh, the humanity! Player 1? In the Grimm fairy tale, The Elves and the Cobbler, a poor shoemaker is given some much-needed help by elves who appear in the middle of the night. And while the shoemaker made a nice profit, the elves were trampled to death on Black Friday. This one's called Okia Dokia. If you're driving between company headquarters, which trip should be the shortest? IKEA to Kia, Kia to Nokia, Nokia to IKEA, or IKEA, Nokia, and Kia headquarters are exactly the same distance apart. Players 1 and 2? No, I'll get this. Nokia is based in Finland, and IKEA is based right next door in Sweden. Kia is based in South Korea. Whether it's phones, furniture, or cars, if it's got Kia in the name, you know it's gonna be cheap. I mean inexpensive. Inexpensive! That brings it close to round one. Remember, in round two, every question is worth double. And don't be afraid to use those screws. You didn't come here to make friends. This one's known as Muscle Milk Was a Bad Choice. Say the news team from the Anchorman films decides to run a relay race against a rival news team. If Ron Burgundy is his team's anchor, when will he run? Before Brick, Brian, and Champ? After Brick and Brian, but before Champ? Before Brian and Champ, but after Brick? Or after Brick, Brian, and Champ? Player one. What a pity. Player two. In a relay race, the anchor, usually the fastest runner, goes last. And they would probably promote the race so incessantly that by the time it actually took place, you wouldn't be that interested in seeing it anymore.
Question 7.
Next. Guess who's Dak? Dak again. You know, I'm not an optimist, but I have to say, I feel like things have been going pretty well with the game so far.
Send Daddy for Dada Dout Knee!
Oh no, my old ventriloquist puppet, Billy O'Brien!
One's made of skin, one's made of wood, so who's the dummy?
Not me!
Billy, the whole creative team here decided to not include you in this game because you're too much of a troublemaker.
Troublemaker? Me? No, I just got back from traveling the world, studying all the profound teachings of titular world spiritual leaders. For instance, which titular religious group was founded by someone with the last name of Snit? Protestants, Episcopalians, Trestitarians, or Nornuns?
Player one.
And you, then excommunicated.
Player two. The Mormon religion was founded in the 1800s by Joseph Smith.
In America.
So, which was your favorite religion you studied?
Well, I particularly like the ones that treats the doubt reincarnation. Someday, I hope to come back as a beautiful coffee table.
Follow me down to the sea.
Archa.
How about Orcas 11? Say I wanted to go around freeing the killer whales from every SeaWorld location in the world. How many separate rescue missions would I need to go on? 3 rescue missions, 4 rescue missions, 5 rescue missions, or 6 rescue missions? Player 2. Player 1. Hey, way to be wrong! Where's that confounded right answer? There are 3 SeaWorlds, one in San Diego, one in San Antonio, and one in Orlando. So you would need to go on 3 separate rescue missions. Well, that sounds like a lot of traveling. Maybe I'll just pay that kid from Free Willy to do it. Something tells me he could use the cash. Take a stab at Kangaroo, Peanuts, Albert Einstein, or Uranus.
Albert Einstein, or Uranus.
The name of Jeff Dunham's purple-skinned puppet. Kangaroo, Peanuts, Albert Einstein, or Uranus. Players 1 and 2. His name is Peanut. I have to admit, people who talk through ventriloquist puppets kind of creep me out.
That you talk through me?
Quiet, Billy. Stop trying to get me to kill people.
Whoa. Now you're creeping me out, man.
Why not try the midnight run to the bathroom? According to Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, how would Paul Revere secretly signal to you that he has to pee in the sea? I have to do a number one in a one. I have to do a number one in a two. I have to do a number one in a three. Or, I have to do a number two in a one. Players 1 and 2? Really? Here's where the money is. According to Henry Wadsworth Longfellow's poem, Paul Revere's Ride, Paul's signal for the British was 1 if by land, 2 if by sea. And as we all know, a number 1 is a P. And Americans would have known about the British sooner if he hadn't stopped for a number 4. You don't even want to know what that is.
Welcome to the attack. When you see 2 clues that match, press the X button. $2,000 if you're right. Oh, I'll just shut my mouth then. Here's your clue. This plus this equals that. What new thing do these combine to make? Good luck.
Dozens of people come through here and post solid wins at this game, but none of them did it like you. They impressed me, and they're all here to say,
you don't know Jack!
Hi, I'm Kyle Pepper, and ever since I was a little boy,
Hi, I'm Cookie Masterson, and whenever I see an attractive woman, I make this sound. I'm very happy to be here with both of you. I'm on a lot of pain medication at the moment. There are your screws to get you started. If you think another player is clueless, screw them and make them answer immediately. If they miss it, you win extra cash. And today's wrong answer of the game is being brought to you by
Slightly Used Balloons. The more these balloons deflate, the more your wallet inflates.
Pick the wrong answer associated with our sponsor to win a fabulous prize and big cash. All right, let's move.
Get ready, time for question.
Let's begin with Mexican-do attitude. What dish could Porky Pig order at a Mexican restaurant without committing cannibalism? Al pastor, chorizo, ceviche, or lomo adobada? Player 2. This is a pork dish. Did you not understand the question? Did I stutter? Oh, that's right, I did. Player 1. Ceviche is fish. Great idea. Give spicy Mexican food to someone who doesn't wear pants.
Oh, mama gonna tell you what I'm gonna do. Say it so.
Open wide for Mark TV 2. We gotta get you back in the game. Take a run at this dis or dat. I'm gonna read off 7 names, and for each one, tell me if it's a sales department on Walmart.com, an MTV show, or both. If it's a Walmart department, press the square button. If it's on MTV, press the circle button. If it's both, press X. Player 1. Try to lock in your answer before player 2, because if player 2 gets it wrong, but you get it right, you'll steal that cash. Cool, let's do it. Bats! Cribs! Mugs! Skins! Juniors! Juvies! Tools! You're a tool. Walmart doesn't have a jackass department, though. Officially.
Dance with me, Disco 3!
Coming up next, just want to check in. Hey, how do you feel? With the pharynx? With the thoracic cavity? With the pulmonary veins? Or with the thalamus? Player 2, watch the time! Players 1 and 2? Located just above the brainstem, the thalamus acts as the relay station, sending information like pain to the brain. That's fine, don't ask me how I'm feeling. I asked you how you feel, but whatever. Sure, it's also with my thalamus, but it's just common decency to reciprocate. Say hello to For Whom the Dinner Bell Tolls. Ooh, it's almost time for my dinner. Better have this fortune cookie first, as prescribed by my doctor.
Cookie, fortune, cookie, fortune, friend. Cookie, fortune, cookie, messenger.
Not bad. Let's see what my fortune says. Laughter is the best medicine. If that's true, which character from the nursery rhyme Hey Diddle Diddle is the healthiest? The cat, the little dog, the cow, or the spoon? Player one. Good effort. Good effort. Player two. Ready for this? In the Mother Goose nursery rhyme, Hey Diddle Diddle, the cat and the fiddle, the little dog is the one that laughs at all the crazy stuff going on. This was pre-YouTube, you understand, so if somebody told you a dog laughed, you just had to take them at their word. I call this one, I've had intimate thoughts about Adam. Which of these people is B.I. curious? Someone interested in sexually experimenting with barium? Someone looking to explore with bromine? Someone flirting with beryllium? Or someone fantasizing about bismuth? Players 1 and 2?
Whoa!
This would have worked. The chemical symbol for bismuth is B.I. But as a society, we shouldn't put labels on things like this, except chemicals. You should label chemicals so you don't blow yourself up. Unless that's what you're into. Look, I don't know, man. That's all we got for round one. Remember, I'm doubling the value of each question in round two. And keep in mind, our wrong answer of the game is still out there waiting to be picked. Let's see what's in store. Here's a good one. Spit up or shut up. If Lady Gaga changed her name to the most common first word spoken by babies, what would she be called? Lady No, Lady Dada, Lady Cats, or Lady Mama? Player 2. Check, please. Player 1. According to a poll performed by YouGov, Dada or Daddy was by far the most popular first word spoken by babies, beating out Mama or Mommy by a considerable margin. Lady Dada is a good name, right? Please just say yes, because that's the name of the screenplay I wrote for Adam Sandler.
Question 7! Get up and shake your monkey bang!
Try this on for size. Childhood murmuries. It looks like we have a sort of treat today. My good acquaintance, old man, somehow found his way into the studio again. How's it going, old man?
Terrible, Mr. Shapiro.
Yeah, it's Mr. Masterson, actually.
Since when?
Since birth.
I know we're on Earth. Anywho, I need your help remembering something.
What's that thing? Who's that fella? Where's that scurly up doodly doo? It's Foggy Facts with Old Man.
Skitty scurly up doo. I forget.
So, what is it you're trying to remember, old man?
Well, it's something I used to do when I was just a lad.
Not sure the history books go back that far, but I'll see if I can help. Why don't you describe it to me?
Sure thing, Nate. It's a game. British kids like to play it, I think. You get 3 strikes per turn, and seeds are involved somehow. What is that game?
Would it be, Conkers, Queenie Queenie, Marbles, or 5 Stones? Player 1. Player 2. You thinking of Conkers, old man?
Hey, Conkers, yeah! And it's an old British kids game I used to play. Each player has one of these seeds called a conker, and they take turns whacking at them. 3 whacks per turn. Why is that fun?
It's hard to imagine you as a little kid, old man.
Well, I look pretty much the same, minus the liver spots. Didn't start growing those till my early 20s.
And when did you start smelling like liver?
That depends. When was liver invented?
Follow me down to the sea.
Take a good look at... All rise for the Honorable Dinwiddie Fudnuddler. If trees brought a class-action lawsuit against lumberjacks, which Dr. Seuss character would they most likely hire as their legal counsel? The Cat in the Hat, the Grinch, Pop, or the Lorax? Players 1 and 2. The Lorax speaks for the trees, and in a lawsuit, the legal counsel speaks for its client, in this case, the trees. It makes sense the Lorax would be a lawyer. He always sues. It's time for... There's a question in my pants, and you're all invited.
It's the put the choices into order, then buzz in and see if you are right. Question!
Okay, as usual, if you get this correct, there's a little extra in it for you. Speaking of extra, put these underwear styles in order from least butt-cheek revealing to most butt-cheek revealing. Thong, bikini, tanga. Bikini, tanga, thong. Tanga, thong, bikini. Thong, bikini, tanga. Or tanga, bikini, thong. Players 1 and 2. Want to see the right answer? Bikini style underwear cover the butt cheeks more than tanga style, and tanga style cover more than thong, which leave your butt cheeks pretty much all out there. But really, any style that doesn't expose my vestigial tail works fine for me. Coming up, feeling fines. I love that actor from Schindler's List and The English Patient. You know, the one who plays Voldemort? But I'm never certain if I'm pronouncing his name correctly. What's the proper way to say that Mr. Fiennes has to throw up? Ralph has to Ralph? Reef has to Ralph? Rolf has to Ralph? Or Rafe has to Ralph? Player one. How do you say, no? Player two. Yep, Rafe Fiennes' first name is spelled like Ralph, but pronounced Rafe. And his brother Joseph Fiennes is pronounced Joseph, but it's spelled L-E-S-S-F-A-M-O-U-S. It's a weird British thing.
Step right up to the Jack Attack. Of course, who wants to hear my yapping? Oh, I'm still doing it. Sorry, here you go. I love you like a legal guardian. I hope you know who adopted or just took care of who.
Player 2!
player two. I'm not exactly sure how you won that game, because from the looks of your score, you played blindfolded. But I do know this.
You don't know Jack!
Thank you. Huh?
It's drawful time. Preparing a 7-player game. There are 7 of you, right? Yep. Let's get things started. Okay, I'm sending a title to each of your devices. Something odd, like square dancing or salami stains. Draw a picture on your device that would have that title, and when you're done, hit send, and you'll get points for each player that can correctly guess your title. So, get to drawing. Have your drawings, and I know what to do with them. Now, use your device to type in what you think the title for this picture could have been, or better yet, something you think could trick the other players into thinking it's the title. You'll get points for every player that picks your answer. All right, here are your choices. Now pick the title you think really inspired this drawing. Pick something. What did everybody pick? Oof, everyone got that one wrong. And now, this. Enter anything that could almost make sense now.
Oh?
choices.
Hey!
Pick something.
Five.
And here are your picks.
Hey!
No correct guesses. Ooh, that hurts. Next up. And here are your choices.
Hey!
Pick something. All right, who picked what? Well, let's not waste any more time on this one. Let's take a look at our next piece of art. Okay, here are your choices. Here's everybody's picks.
Hey!
game.
I like this group of players. I don't know why. I just do. And this one. And here are your choices. And here are your picks. Okay, well, that was that. Type in your titles now. Here are your choices. All right, who picked what? This really begs the question, what is an acceptable amount of poop? And our next weird doodle. Okay, here are your choices.
Ah!
pick something.
Five.
What did everybody pick? Okay, so that happened.
Hey!
Welcome to the game. My name's Cookie, and this is the best day of my life. A four-person game, I see. I can work with that. Let's do this. This is round one. You'll get 500 points for everyone you fool, and you'll get 1,000 for finding the truth. Select a category. Okay, here's your first question. After an allergic reaction to steroids used to treat asthma, a 28-year-old woman started growing blank on her head instead of hair. Now, use your device to enter a bluff that you think will fool the other players into thinking it's true. If you can't think of anything in time, use the Lie for Me button for half the points. Do it now! Hurry up! Use a suggestion if you can't think of anything. Okay, here are your choices. Find the truth and touch it on your device. Okay, what did everyone pick? Now when she wants to look nice, she goes out and gets a Manny Hetty. And the rest of the board goes unselected. Alright, pick a category. Okay, here's the question. In 1726, a British woman named Mary Toft convinced doctors that she had given birth to blank. Enter your lies now. Okay, here you go. Find the truth. Let's see what everybody selected. And it was also... Great minds think alike. And that's it. Nobody else's lies got picked. Time to pick a category. Okay, here's the question. Moviegoers who use their cell phones at the Prince Charles Cinema in London are escorted out by people dressed as blank. Type in your lies now. Use a suggestion if you can't think of anything. Okay. And we're done. This is round two, which means all point values are doubled. Exciting. Select a category.